Yeah, I never played fair. So tell me why now should we care? Queen B told y'all a long time ago that we run the atmosphere. Did we build that? Yeah. Do we own that? Yeah. We even in the studios running playback. Shout out to Air Miss Sally, the young guards, to all the G's like us. Yeah, we go hard. See, this is how we feel it, be a champion. We might fall down, but we never run.
You wouldn't need it if you knew what we overcome.
Do you know what we gotta overcome?
But they ain't stopping nothing. Me and my girls on top, straight stunting. And we abide by a real strict code. Hands off my ex and homies over.
If you try to shut us down, we'll show you just how we get down.
The young guard to all the girls like us, yeah, we go hard. See, this is how we feel to be a champion. We might fall down, but we never run.
So proud of the that we overcome.
Do you know
we bow down to none. I want to hail out all my dear ones. Time really does fly when you're having fun. But the party don't stop till we staring down the sun.
Try to shut us down. We'll show you just how we get down. And just to even up the score, we're coming kicking down your door.
I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned into the NFL on EA Sports. Some serious pride on the line in this contest as these two divisional rivals take the field together for the first time this season. Almost a playoff atmosphere surrounding the game between these two bitter opponents.
It's the Eagles going up against the Egyptians.
With that, we'll send it over to Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis. They've got the call in this Week 5 matchup.
All right, Larry, thank you very much. We are pleased, as always, to be bringing you coverage of the National Football League presented by EA Sports. Tonight, we wind up Week 5 with a good battle between the Philadelphia Eagles and the Memphis Egyptians. Here going down back at the 28. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
One of the toughest things for an offensive lineman to learn is the ability to get in space and hit people who are moving targets. And linebackers are not easy ones to hit because they know how to move, juke, and make you miss. And that's exactly what he did on that play. A nice play for the defense.
It's already second and 12. The defense hoping to push them back more. They'll look to throw. He's going to let this one go deep. He's got it at the 15. And he is taken down deep in Philadelphia territory. Well, we know he's got the speed there. He needed the speed and the hands. A great catch.
And because of that speed, you have to respect it as a defender. So you have to either play off or make sure you're somehow in contact with him, and he's able to do exactly what you said. Use the speed to his advantage and go up and get the football. That's a big-time play right there.
And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. Nothing on that one. It'll be second down. And when this offense is clicking on all cylinders, the running back is in sync as well.
The focal point. Runs, catches, blocks, sets the tone for the offense.
They try again with Smallwood. And running room hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8. It's a pickup of 3, but still a little work to do on 3rd and goal. And we peek at the defense now for Philadelphia.
Jordan Hicks played inside and outside linebacker while in college. He'll do the same in the NFL and make a lot of plays in doing so.
Can this defense get the stop on the opening drive? Here's 3rd and goal.
Here we go now. Boom,
Leopard, Leopard.
Looking to throw. And he fires one that's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And to the 12. That's where it stops. The return is halted at the 12-yard line. Charles, a nice play there, wasting no time making his presence felt for this defense.
And you know, we heard the same conversation around the league. A lot of people were surprised that he was available, and they let him go. And now he's going to make a big-time impact with his new squad.
And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. They'll run it now out of the gun. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a 2nd and 2.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but a guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
So this brings up a 2nd and 2. Now Wentz throwing on 2nd down. And try to get it to his tight end, Rodgers, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And they will take over at the 29-yard line. Now this offense ready to head back out there. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
Out to the left here to Reed. Throw, and this one's incomplete. Well, good field position to start the drive, but under the gun now here on 3rd and 8. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And oh, he's going to be hit and driven into the turf. Fletcher Cox in there to drop him for a 6-yard loss, and that'll lead to a 4th down. And this one is right down the middle. And that'll make it 3-0 here in the first. So after the pick, they can't capitalize for six, but they do get three.
And I know in this situation, most of us wanted to focus on the offense. You know what side of the ball I played on. Let's give that defense a lot of credit, taking it over in a sudden change situation and shutting them down.
Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I'm here my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
No gain, and it's second down. And if this offense is going to flow today, certainly the running back will be a key piece.
Without a doubt, because they asked their runner to not just do that, but to block, to catch, to help set a tone for their offense.
On second down, here's Wentz. Incomplete. And here are the defensive starters. In your old position, you get to talk about the secondary.
The best athletes on the field, Brandon.
Ah, debatable.
Well, we'll see how this goes today. I love the way you put my guys down. But you know this, they've got to cover and they have to tackle. They have a heck of a task in front of them in this game.
Rolling to his right. Now on the run. He'll throw it back. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. A great job pulling that one in from a guy, as we know, who can really blaze. He's got a lot of speed.
And that speed can work for him so many different ways. Sometimes he just takes off and goes and just runs past people. Sometimes you get people to back off so far that you can catch everything underneath. But still, at some point in the game, you probably have to make some contested catches, right? Sometimes you have to go up and beat a defender for the football. He has that in his arsenal as well.
Showed it right there. Here on first down, he's going to float this one deep right side. So they took a shot on first down but couldn't connect.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had to fly, just sending a guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route. They went for the guy on the fly, but as you said, incomplete. Again, they'll throw with Wentz. Bryant with a catch right side. And he'll go down at the 28. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down.
We just saw an example of what we talk about all the time when we meet with coaches. They want that hidden yardage to come to the front when they throw the football. Throw it, catch it, and then pick up more yardage after the catch.
Offense coming up, needing 2 yards on third down. Wentz looking to throw on third and two. And he can't come up with a pick. Nearly his second of the game. Instead, fourth down. Well, he just threw an interception last drive, nearly another pick.
And things aren't very even right now, are they? It's a little bit sloppy out there, isn't it? It's kind of different driving on those paved roads and those country roads that have those potholes in them, isn't it? Because that's the way this game's going right now. A lot of bouncity bounce to it.
You spent some time on some Tennessee country roads.
I certainly have. Plenty of family back there. God love them.
On fourth down, here's Pat McAfee to kick it away. So the flag is for roughing the kicker, a big 15-yard penalty.
And I'm not sure that was the time to go all out after the kicker. Plenty of time left in this game.
So they're operating in the red zone.
Here we go now. Boom, land it.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And He's going to work this one down to about the 5. 9 yards is the pick up there, and they'll have a 2nd and 1.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
Jordan Matthews, the one he was looking for. And it's 3rd and short. Maybe just a lack of concentration there as he couldn't haul it in.
And when you're going across the middle like that, you know, he's running that drag route, you are conscious of all the bodies and the traffic in there. But let's face it, if you're going there, you might as well come down with the football and absorb whatever else happens after that.
Now flags come in here. Look like one of the Eagles might have moved. So it's 3rd and 6, and this will be the 8th play of the drive. They'll run it now, out of the gun. Just a 1 yard pickup there, and it'll be 4th down.
Well, this was just simply excellent defense. On this 3rd down, they had to be alert for the possibility of a pass, but that didn't stop them at all from understanding what was going on when they decided to run the football, and they just swarmed and stuffed them for almost no gain.
And Hopkins' kick is good, and that will tie us at 3-3. So in the end, they had the ball for 10 plays, but the drive only yields 3 points.
Yeah, they were able to move the football, but the defense stiffened once their backs were to the end zone, and they were able to hold them to just 3.
And they'll be set up pretty nicely here as they have it up to the 35-yard line. Now this offense ready to take over again. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put 6 on the board here. We'll see.
Not a big run on the first play of the drive, but that doesn't necessarily mean it was a bad play. Sometimes you're just trying to settle in, get your guys a little bit of contact, and get things moving.
Shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. And the offense needs 7 out of this play on 3rd down.
4 down. Hurry up, here we go. Over. Watch it now, Barney.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. 15 yards there for number 15. Back with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. It's Memphis with the ball here to begin quarter number 2, and they've got it here with a 1st down.
No, Jack Patriot.
They come out here in the eye. 1st down, a run with Smallwood. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards is the tally on 1st down. That brings up 2nd and 5.
And that's exactly what you want on a 1st down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up 2nd and 5. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up 2nd down here.
Four down. Let's go.
They'll drop to throw. He rifles one that's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. The 20. And they will finally bring this run back to an end, but not before he's...